information online. Now, I know this is a game has been out a while in the East, but this is kind of new to me, and I started having a look online, and there wasn't that many videos showcasing character creation and different classes, so I thought I'd make one. Let me just adjust the settings here, one second. Yeah, I've had to put it on display, so unfortunately my monitors aren't working great at the moment. So, as you can see, it's a kind of very Eastern looking MMO by my.com. We've also done like Skyforge and All Odds Online, or All Odds Online, whatever you want to call it. So I expect a similar kind of feel to it. It's free to play at the moment. I'm not sure whether that's going to change. I've already made a gunslinger, as you can see here. Looks pretty cool. Characters are all kind of quite Eastern looking, but there's a decent amount of character creation, as you can see. So I'm going to choose a different class to play. So you can see here we've got Vanguard. So they seem to be sort of the tank. The UI is not great here because it's kind of hidden by everything. Sword Mage. See here. Range Magic and Crow Control. She's quite interesting because she still has a sword, but she does actual ranged attacks with magic emanating from the sword, which is quite cool. Gunslinger has awesome big guns and I believe can turn into some kind of mech. There we go, Blade Master. There we go, we can zoom out on those. There's a Blade Master here. Physical melee attack, crowd control. So that's kind of another tank, I think that one is. Assassin is the usual kind of physical attack, backstabbing, stealth, toxins. That's pretty cool armor, I think you'll agree. Spirit Shaper, that is the healing support ranged character. This is magic. Now some of these are gender locked, I believe, so, but as you'll probably see from character creation, it is quite inclusive. I started making my gunslinger and found you could have quite a, I'm pretty sure it was a feminine looking face, maybe even been an actual female face on a male body. There's definitely female style haircuts on a male body, so that's pretty cool. But this is the one I want to try out tonight. This is the Occultist. There we go. So this is the ranged magic attack and a healing support. I do like my DPS, especially ranged DPS, so thought I'd gotta try this person out here. So you can specialise in healing, support, magic attack for this one. So let's have a look and see what we've got here. Pretty awesome. I'm gonna be a bit disappointed if this is gender locked, but we will see. There she goes. Nice animation there. So we can try. So we can have three different types of female. And can we have a male? Oh yeah, I think, you know what, there's going to be plenty of females around in this game because of the the boobage basically, so I'm I'm not that kind of person, really. So I will go for a male character on this this time round. Definitely not into the cutesy thing. So let's go for the tall, gothic-looking male. That looks pretty awesome. Now comes the bit which may take a little while. So you got some sort of presets here to start off with. Some pretty neat stuff. You see what I mean about the hairstyles? I mean, that's quite feminine, which is fine, that's cool. Oh, that looks pretty neat. Very androgynous. I like it. Black skin, black hair even. I like that body, but with that face. Change all of this stuff anyway. So let's have a quick look at that body. It was a lot taller, broader shoulders. I don't know what I do quite like, because it's quite thin. Let's change the hair maybe. I'm gonna flick through a few of these, but I'm pretty happy with that hairstyle, I think. Again, I mean, that looks like a woman with a male body, so this is quite cool that you can make it look that feminine. It's pretty neat. Got a few different ones here. I'm just gonna flick through some of them quickly. Don't wanna be on this too long. And I know people want to see the gameplay as well, so. Pixie like. Yeah, that's pretty neat. I like that. But I'm gonna go with this one, I think. Hair colours. Nice. If they're going to be an occultist, they've got to have some pretty wicked hair colour, right? Not fond of the red. Green. I think I like the white, maybe. Slightly grey. Yeah, that's cool. Skin. So this is quite interesting. You can actually do all the hair edit. Yeah, you can actually determine the skin luster, so how shiny it is, which you can't see very well on this one. But if I turn it to a darker color, you can make yourself extremely shiny and very bright, or not so bright. And lots of shiny. I'm gonna put it a little bit of shine there, but I think. It's just probably going to look as pallid as possible. So let's leave it like that. So let's see now. Head size, I think, is about proportionate to the body, so I'm not going to mess with that. Maybe make the shoulders a bit. Maybe leave them as they are. Shoulder. This is all stuff you can really get your teeth into. Make the hands massive. That would be cool with the giant gloves, right? Although it probably doesn't affect that, thinking about it. Slightly long hands. There we go. Legs. Change the buttocks so you can't see them. What does that do? Let's just leave that alone. Leave that where it is. Waist length, calf length. foot size. Give yourself giant feet. Or tiny feet. Body, let's see if we can make them maybe a little bit taller. That's as large as you can make them, really, like, in terms of body fat. But that's now for the face. Let's have a look at this face colour. Beards. Wow, make him look like he's, oh my goodness, he's prepubescent, or just prepubescent. Tattoo, I'm not sure if I like that tattoo. You can even do a bit of bleach there. Bit of a scar, I think, for that one. Change the tattoo colour to whatever you want. Blue. That looks pretty neat. Wrinkles. Oh, you can make yourself really haggard here, look. This. Looks a bit strange with the face that I've selected, with the colour of the face that I've selected, so let's turn it down a bit. Bit of wrinklage. Nobody's skin is that perfect. Let's stay with that. Got some bushy eyebrows, thin eyebrows. There we go, I think I'll go with those ones. Again, you can change the bright colour and all of the different things. Eye size. Pretty happy with this. I'm not gonna spend ages on these as well. Pupil pattern, so this is pretty cool. Change it from a cat. Something swirly, that's pretty neat. Just do that, that's pretty cool. And you can change independent colours. Shape. I couldn't see much difference in this last night. I can't really tell what's going on there. Change the colour of the glare. Interesting. If you can see that with that little highlights changing. Makeup, I'm not. I don't know whether I'm going to touch this, but. See, that's cool. I like the fact that the males can wear makeup as well. That's awesome. A bit more dramatic, maybe, because I am an occultist after all. Lips. Again, I'm not going to mess with this because I'm pretty happy with the lips. arm, you can adjust pretty much everything here, so I might just adjust the chin or the lower jaw shape. Yeah, give him a bit more fullness. I'm pretty happy with that. Is it man? Is it woman? Who cares? Doesn't really matter. Cool. So you can test him in different poses and different outfits as usual. That must be the top end gear. Yeah, look cool. Let's create that then. Here we go, let's see what this gameplay is like then, finally. So, I didn't spend a massive amount of time on this last night, but enough to get to level 11, which didn't take too long, probably about an hour, something like that. As I say, I think this has been out for a while in the East. Only came out probably about a year ago here, I'm not sure. It doesn't seem to be much about it around, so that's kind of good in one way, but bad in another. I'm going to try this action mode because I did enjoy games like Terror, which included that, so let's try that for now.
Use the WASD keys to move your character.
And you just use Alt if you want to bring the mouse back up. As probably expected with a free-to-play game, there's
put
not these login
name
rewards.
In the quest tracking interface to initiate auto pathfinding.
Auto pathfinding. Zoom in on this because I don't like such a far out view.
In case you forget, Aria told us to help out with the Sea God Festival tonight. Let's hurry over and help out.
Quite a few different, battle moves where you're sprinting and you can dash in the air, that kind of thing. So I assume those will come in later into combat.
I knew it! You were hiding here, you loafer!
She's a real wimpy character, but... So in the, in the action mode, this is what you get. You get a little line indicating which thing you are targeting, which is quite useful when you've got lots of stuff going on screen. And you can also tab to lock on to it, which changes the icon. And if I do something else, I can lock on to something else, that kind of thing. So let's see what we got here. We got... So, yeah, dodge to cancel that. So that's a one you have to sit in the channel. Let's have a look. Demon's Rancors. So yeah, we have to stay still for that, I think. Grasping Spirits. Recovers HP for party members. All does damage. Chef. I can see how much taller my character is than some of these guys. Weird because the reticule is quite far up the screen, as you can see. Well, it doesn't really seem to have, I'm not really found it to be annoying yet, so that's
a bonus. Uncle Tanzir, just focus on preparing for the feast. I'll help you take care of the rest of the ingredients. Please, try this new outfit before you go.
Click on the equip button to complete the quest. For action mode players, press Alt to bring up the cursor.
So once we've got to a bit of combat, I'll show you the other mouse modes. Let's just cancel this. Click on this because it's annoying me. Online for 5 minutes, yay! Here we go, I can change some of these settings now and show you the combat for different ones. Oh look, this poor guy's being bullied. Little egg.
Attack the monsters with your skills. Attack the Sedgelings with your skills. Attack the Sedgelings with your skills.
I see this is an area of effect, so... Ah, okay, so they're placing it anyway. Alright. That's pretty neat. Okay, so let's try... Okay, I didn't know we've got two different states, but let's have a look at the settings and try the other... So, keyboard mode is the more traditional one. So now it's a place of pressing tab to target. You still get this line, but you can tab target. You don't have to be facing. Yeah, so the buttons that were on, the skills that were on your mouse button are now moved to the bar. To be honest, this might be a better option for this class because of placing the area of effects. It does give you recommended classes and stuff. Right, so I'm going to try the controls. Mouse mode. So now you click to move in this mode here. And again, the skills that were on the mouse are move to your taskbar. action bar rather. This is kind of Diablo-ish. We have to pick to move. Although you can still. Can still use WASD, so yeah, that's confusing. Let's try combat action mode again, and just want to try out that area of effect again. Any movement cancels that.